Hey guys, I hope everybody's doing good. Once again, my best wishes to all of you. Well, I got sidetracked again with some medical issues. Nothing too serious, but I noticed I missed out on some great content out there. I'll try and catch up. I want to thank everybody for the shout outs in their videos. Yes, it's much, much appreciated. Of course, again, I missed out on Two for Tuesday and way back Wednesday. But we'll try and make up with it with a response to the open tag of three fixed blade pocket knives. Now, you'll see two of these have a sheath made for belt carry, but they're all small enough where you can just drop in your pocket if you're in a hurry. So let's get right to it. I got another day that I'm going to be spending at the doctor's. Again, nothing serious, just all routine stuff. So anyway, let's take a look. First, let's go right to the LT Wright Bush Baby. And you'll see what a beautiful sheath that they give you when you buy one of these. It also has a dangler, which I removed, which would be up to here, so it would even carry lower on your belt. But this way I can just drop it in my pocket, no problem, if I'm on the run. I got a fire steel ordered for it. With a curly birch handle, should look pretty cool. But let's take a look at it. It's 01 tool steel. It's a 2.8 inch blade, saber grind. And you'll see the LT Wright stamp there. And I don't know what the O is. I'm wondering if that's some kind of date code. Nice saber grind. Black canvas micarta with the toxic green liner. And check this out, you guys. Got all these Rite Aid receipts for prescriptions. Of course, it's not made for cutting paper. There we go. Just got to get the right angle on it. But anyway, it's nice and sharp. Two-point-inch blade, an eighth of an inch stock, full tang, lanyard hole. If you look at the pins in here, they got brass eyelets. Really tight fit and finish. And I'm telling you guys, this is the one of the most comfortable knives in hand that I own. You can also kind of move up here a little bit. There's no choil, but you're not going to get cut. So hopefully one day I'll get up to the hardware store, maybe get some fat wood, and we'll see if we can strike a little fire with it. Just a cool knife, spear point. Let's get an overall length. About 6 3/4. So your handle is almost 4 inches. But my hand fits perfect on it. Of course, I got smaller hands. but really nice fit there. Just love this thing. And of course it comes with the cool sheath. It's brown, but it's darkened. I guess that's from the coating they put on it. You'll see the brown here. So it looks more like a black. But yeah, that'll drop right down in the pocket, no problem. Second one up is definitely made for pocket carry. Has the pocket clip. This is made by Boker. There's your chestnut tree. And it's the Boker Burnley Barlow. Boker Solingen. There's Burnley as the designer. And it's made out of AEBL steel with the stone wash and, or actually an acid wash. Clip point, also with a saber grind. Now this one here has, I think the blade is a little bit bigger. No, it's probably actually smaller. 2 3/4 inch. The blade, the handle is definitely smaller, just over 3 inches. Green canvas micarta, full tang, no liners. Just a really cool knife. And of course, again, one of the coolest sheaths around. And this one, it can go in either way depending on what pocket you have it in. I like to carry it this way in my right pocket. So it'll come out actually this way, because it'll be hooked into the inside of your pocket here as it falls right in there. Simply gorgeous blade there. And then if I want to go old school, and this one I've dropped in my pocket many times. Sheath was made by J.O. J.O. Ventures Outdoors. And it's a side draw. But it'll also just drop right in your pocket. And it's one of the old vintage old timers by Schrade. Carbon steel. It's the 154 OT drop point. Just a really fun knife to carry here, especially if you feel like going old school. Delrin handle, full tang. Really smoothed out. Feels great in the hand. You can get up on this one too here. As you'll see, the blade edge doesn't really start to right there. So you got all this. It's not going to cut you. And get in, do some detail work. So yeah, that's it for today. Like I said, I'm going to try and get caught up. I've seen a lot of you guys were putting out some great content that I want to catch up on. Also want to give a shout out to Kevin over at Boston Blade Reviews. Sent me out a sticker. Still got the Singing Toad up here. If you haven't subscribed to him yet, I'll put a link for both these guys down in the description box. And I felt it was appropriate to put a buck sticker next to Boston Blade, since he has a magnificent buck collection. And there's just some things that I was warming up again. Here's the two for Tuesday that I missed. And here is a gift Tom gave me that's been finding its way in my left pocket quite a bit because it's very lightweight. So I guess that's it. We'll take a look. Let's take a look at these. Whoops. That worked out pretty good. Let's take a look at these outside of the sheaths. Give you an idea of the size of them. So until next time, my friends, take care. Peace. Bye-bye. Thank you.